What is up, guys? Tommy H here, and welcome back to another video regarding Kong vs. Godzilla in 2020. So, obviously, this is by far one of, if not the most anticipated battle of all time, regardless of the franchise. This is without question the Batman vs. Superman of the MonsterVerse, but even a comparison like that does not showcase how epic this battle really is. These are not human beings with superpowers, these are very dangerous monsters. In their own universes, they are considered kings and gods.
Kong's god on the island.
But within every single discussion regarding these two monsters, there always seems to be the hurdle of getting Kong and Godzilla to meet. Of course, Godzilla is located in Japan and Kong is on Skull Island, so unless Godzilla were to swim over to Skull Island, this battle may very well not take place. So far, Kong has not showed us that he can swim great distances. The only time he was taken away from Skull Island to fight Godzilla was back in 1962. That whole battle was kind of lackluster. Of course, they did dress up in suits, so the very intense, realistic factors that will be showcased in 2020 were not there. But one aspect of the first official Godzilla King of the Monsters trailer that many people noticed, myself included, was this shot right here. Now, I did talk about this in my initial breakdown video, and I still believe what I said. Like we all know, around Skull Island is a perpetual storm system, and the only way for anybody to get to the actual island is through that storm. So, I will be giving you guys my theory as to what this shot is all about. Now, this theory is a bit modified from my breakdown video, but for the most part, it has some similarities. Like I said before, the only way to get to Skull Island is by passing the storm system. This storm is very dangerous and very deadly, especially for human beings. Now, one aspect of Godzilla King of the Monsters that has been explored by Dr. Emma Russell's character is communicating with these kaijus. Now, one kaiju in specific has always kind of been an ally of the human race. This kaiju, of course, is Mothra. And going back to Dr. Emma Russell's character, she did say that she can talk to these monsters and lead them in a certain way. So with Monarch going all across the world to wake these monsters up, we could see Mothra, Rodan, and Godzilla take out King Ghidorah, and then the final monster to wake up is Kong. Now, at the very end of this movie, we could see Dr. Emma Russell's character bring a crew over to Skull Island, and they would be sailing with Mothra ahead of them. Once they arrive at Skull Island, Mothra goes above the storm, flaps her wings, and gets rid of it. They may have gone on this boat thinking it was big enough to drag Kong back to mainland, but right when that storm goes away, Kong would be standing there at over 350 feet in height. Bigger than he has ever been, Kong is revealed, and the movie ends. That would be ideal for me and everybody who's a big fan of Kong Skull Island. As Mike Doherty did say, there will be hints and clues of Kong's appearance, so in my opinion, this is a great way of getting Kong off the island, and it's a great segue into Kong vs. Godzilla. But what are your thoughts on the sequence right here? Why is Mothra flapping her wings? Is this Skull Island? And why have they brought a boat? Write this all down below, and if you guys are new to the channel, subscribe if you want, and if you enjoy this video, leave a like, and have a nice day.